This is the Division III Girls Soccer Championships right here at Scotland Yard, Bakersfield, California. This is playonsports.com here with you. Michael Conowitz, Manny Nunez here making the call. It is the Liberty Hawks, 22-3-3 overall, taking on the host team, the Highland Scots, record of 19-16-2. About to get underway in just a little bit here. Again, alongside Michael Conowitz, Manny Nunez here making the call. How they got here up to this point here to host the final, the number one seed Highland team out of bye in the first round, and in the corner in semifinals took down Independence and Central Valley Christian, for that matter, for the other squad, for Liberty, Madera, Ranchos. 2 hours north of in Fresno, California, they had a bye and defeated Porterville and East Bakersfield, the number two seed, coming in this into this matchup. Now, Michael, real quick, although Liberty does have the better record coming into this game, obviously Highland has the advantage with home field advantage. What do the Hawks need to do to overcome that such feat?
Well, they got to come out fast. The Hawks have to come out fast. That's one of the issues we have. One of the issues for the Highland, that is, has been needing to come out fast. Highland has come out slow in a couple of their playoff games, gone down. So if Liberty can get a quick early lead, maybe finally overcoming the statistical probability for Highland, that is, of coming back. That's been an issue for Highland. If you can get on top of Highland early, that could be really bode well for Liberty.
Now, you talk about these final games. As a matter of fact, no matter who you face off in the final matchup, it's always going to be one of these 2-1, 1-0 affairs, obviously favoring either side. But again, for Liberty, they've got, as you mentioned, the better standing. So, you know, this will be basically a matchup of, obviously, who can really withstand the most fatigue. Although it is an 80-minute matchup, the last 10 minutes of soccer are both the most difficult, as you see a kickoff right into the hands of the Liberty goalie. But again, for Liberty, you know, this team has a lot of experience going into this game. But again, against taking on Highland, it'll be a very tough matchup, as it'll be one of the tightest matchups they'll face this year.
Yeah, we really are seeing the top of D3 soccer here. Liberty has won 13 in a row, hasn't lost since January. Actually has a little bit of a higher national and state ranking, according to MaxPreps.com, than Highland does. But Highland's won 11 straight after starting out their season a little rough, losing three of their first four games. They've won 11 straight, and Highland has so much offensive talent all over the field. They actually have just two of their midfielders in Paige Jano and Peyton Armijo have scored 36%, 29 goals of the Highland offense.
Yeah, this team, as a matter of fact, three of the players, as you mentioned, for the Scott squad have actually scored in double figures. Two players have scored 17, as a matter of fact, Peyton Armijo and Paige Janot, who have scored 17 overall, and then Alexia Gonzalez, the other player, with double figures with 12. But you also have to mention the goalie as well, Samantha Abarca, who has 76 total saves, but the more impressive stat, 12 shutouts, and that might be a big factor coming into tonight.
Absolutely. Big saves are going to be important when the offenses get going.
For Liberty, they'll be dressed in all green with white numbering, the Highland host team in all whites with green lettering front and back. Goalie saved there by Liberty on the short chip, and now here comes the Scots as they're up along the far side. 50-50 ball will move it down to the far side as Liberty here, or correction, the Scots will kick it away. A chance now on the attack here for the Hawks as they'll take it up along the far side out of bounds. Again, in these first 15-20 minutes, it's kind of more or less trying to get a feel of what the team is trying to do. You're trying to see what kind of holes both these teams are trying to create. So, like we said, it's all about fatigue. And this factor, you kind of want to save it towards the end. But in these first 15-20, it's kind of trying to see where this team can make their mistakes.
And, you know, Liberty really good on the road, 6-1 on the season. But Highland undefeated here at home. And also with the advantage of playing on this field, and as you can see, a pretty raw Scotland Yard, almost like we're in Scotland in February here. Very little grass, and of course Highland has the advantage of having played on this if you call it field, pitch all season. So we'll see how the ball bounces. Probably going to bounce a little faster players could slip, so that'll be another thing to watch.
One thing you may not consider here, it actually rained all throughout the midweek here on Tuesday and Wednesday. And on Tuesday, that's when the semifinal games were played, as a matter of fact. It was a very wet conditions, and as a matter of fact, there was a lot of standing water for both teams to kind of face off. A chance for the Scots, and a dive save there by Allison Seether to save the 0-0 shutout. Beautiful move there by Seether on the kick from the Scots, but a great athletic ability there by Seether to make the dive save. Now the chance for the Scots. Instead, they'll kick it out of bounds along the far side, and already we've seen the first attack here from the Scots, and it almost paid off.
Yeah, it really did a really good job of setting that up. Got players in front or behind the Liberty defense, but a good save.
So now here comes the Hawks as they'll take it out of bounds as the ball went way deep into the corner of the pitch. Again, rain really played a factor in the semifinal games between both of these teams. For Highland, they won 2-1. They actually trailed against Central Valley Christian. They were down 1-0, but then two goals in the second half excelled them down to victory. But then for Madera Ranchos, or Liberty Madera Ranchos for that matter, they ended up winning their game also by a final of 2-1 as well. They did not trail. They actually had a 2-0 lead the whole way until they gave up that last goal, the unnecessary goal in the second half. Now the Scots here trying to fight its way through. A foul call. It'll be against the Scots. The ball here will go the other way. 6 minutes already into this contest. No score, but already one chance so far here for the Scots.
Ball. Pretty good offensive possessions for both teams thus far, setting up some good plays and getting deep into the territory, setting up chances. So both offenses starting out pretty decently.
Along the far side, off the feet of number 8, Samantha Abarca, who lets it go out of bounds. Now here comes Liberty with a throw-in. Again, about 7 minutes into this one, still no score here in the Division III girls soccer final, the central section right here on playonsports.com. Ball juggled around, going out of bounds right into the Highland bench. It'll be a throw-in here for the Scots. And both these teams here looking for that central championship crown. Two valiant teams, as Michael mentioned. Highland, although the lower rank in the national and state rank, 358th in the nation, 185th in the state, Liberty, 141st overall here in the state of California. Ball along the far side picked up by the Highland goalie, Rebecca Vega. Kicked away down to midfield. Liberty trying to gain control, but Highland on top of the ball. Now here come the Hawks as they try to take it away, but it's going to be kicked off the feet of the Scots. A chance here for the Hawks as they'll put it into the Scots zone. On the throw in here, number 11, Randy Wallace, the captain, who throws it right into the Scots box, but no one there to chase it after, as it'll go right over the line here for a gold kick. 8 minutes into this one, again, no score. As we mentioned, both teams trying to just get to a little sense of what both of these teams have to offer. As you mentioned, Michael, two teams coming in with a double-digit winning streak for Liberty, 13 in a row. The Scots coming in winning 11 straight. Obviously, one of these teams will have their winning streak snapped, but again, in this final game, it's going to be all or nothing at this point. A chance at a cross taken away there by the Scots as they'll move it up along the far side. Out of bounds, a mishap there by the Scots as the Hawks will inbound it near the goal box.
So a good opportunity for the Hawks, but Liberty looking a little bit sharper in their offensive possessions, and just so much experience as they're, you know, the two-time defending champions here and playing at home, a big advantage for the Scots.
On the chip, and a scoop-up made there by Vega, who's right on top of that one. A great cross pass, but Vega read that like a book and scooped it up for the save. Ball now at midfield. The Highland Scots trying to muscle its way through, and there is Peyton Armijo along the near side, headed away off the head there of number 12, Emma Tucker. As the Scots now this time will try to take advantage here inside the Hawks zone. But 10 minutes into this one, still no score. Ball now near the middle of the pitch. Up along now towards the far side. The Hawks touching the balls. They'll force it right near midfield into the Highland bench. Great defensive play there to at least set up the defense here for the Hawks. Ball along the far side. Scott's trying to gain control, but there's two Liberty players on top of it as they'll force it out. Now here comes a chance at a fast break, but instead it's mishandled there. And now here come the Scots with a possible opportunity. Ball up through the middle. Juggled around, a whistle. And I believe a foul called against the Hawks. The Scots will here get a free kick.
A good job just moments ago by Jovan of stealing that one back after it looked like Liberty might have an opportunity, but now they get it right back.
Yeah, they actually switched the foul call. It'll be against the Hawks instead. Free kick here for the Hawks, but instead they'll try to chip it all up along the near side. In control with it is Olsen along the near side, trying to pass it to one of her players along the line. It'll be out of bounds, though, last touch by the Scots. So the throw in here will come up along the near side, right in front of the Hawks bench. About 11 minutes into this one, still no score. Both teams, or this game, will actually be played in two 40-minute halves. It'll be a running clock unless a goal is scored. The referee does also have the time on the field, and in the last 10 minutes of the second half, the clock will actually be directed at the referee. A chance at a shot, but instead it's scooped up there by Rebecca Vega, and she'll kick it away down towards midfield.
Pretty good job, Joe, though, of Bridget Brunel of working in the space between her defenders, and a good opportunity for her.
Vega again sees that ball trickle right into their hands as the Hawks were trying to get a chance at a fast break, but instead Vega on top of the ball, kicked away over at midfield, and now the Scots trying to regain control, but instead the Hawks will try to dish it over, a chance at a one-on-one break, but again Vega right in front. A lot of breaks here for the Hawks so far, and it seems as if in these first 12 minutes or so, they've got the heavy hand.
They have in the last couple minutes. They're getting some good opportunities. Seems like they may need maybe more, a little better passing. It seems like individually they're playing pretty well with the ball, but they aren't quite setting up enough offense in terms of team offense.
Scott's with a chance along the goal line, trying to keep it in bounds. It goes right over the goal and out of bounds. And as we mentioned, the Hawks with a couple of chances there where the Scots on the play. A great setup, but instead the pass went a little bit too far, ending up as a goal kick. So about 13 and a half minutes into this one so far. Still no score. Again, both three teams still trying to shake off those cobwebs from a couple of days ago as they played their semifinal matchup to get to this point.
And Liberty, of course, had their game delayed by rain. They just played a couple of days ago. So another advantage, maybe at least, for Highland, who played their game a couple days before that, have a couple more days to rest up and watch their opponent get ready, really sit back and scout.
I guess the one thing you can say that it might be a better day today than a couple days ago is definitely the weather, although it will get down to, I believe, the low 50s, high 40s by the end of the game. At least it wasn't like it was a couple days ago when it was raining, really cold. You had that Alaska air coming in from the north. It was just not a pleasant day for soccer, but both these teams definitely had to fight it out. And as you mentioned, for Liberty having their game delayed because of rain, luckily for Highland, they had a chance to play their game, though they had a lot of standing water in their matchup. Here come the Hawks on the chance of the attack. They'll stolen away. Foul call there against Alexia Gonzalez as she stuck a foot out against the defender. Free kick here for the Hawks. Up along the near side, about 35 yards away from goal.
Definitely keep an eye there on number 10 there in the middle. On your screen, Bridget Brunel has been doing a really good job when she gets her hands on the ball.
Free kick into the bunch, but it goes right over the pile. A chance at a shot, but instead goes well out, about 10 yards off the goal. Free kick coming now for the Scots. And again, 14 minutes into this one, Liberty squad, again, showing as if they are, right now, at least a little bit of the better team thus far. They've had a little bit more of a shot advantage compared to the Scots, although the Scots have had a couple of breaks in the early stages. Ball out of bounds. Last touch there by the Hawks. The Scots will take it out of bounds along the far side.
Yeah, it felt like the Scots' chances early were maybe a little better set up than Liberty's were, but Liberty has definitely owned the possession in the last several minutes.
Ball here thrown in from midfield. Here comes the Scots at a chance at the attack, but the Hawks well on top of the ball as they'll try to force it out back to midfield. Though the Scots right back on top of it. The Hawks, though, kick it away off the feet of Randy Wallace. Now the ball along the far side at midfield. Last touch there by the Scots as they could not control the ball in front of their feet. Hawks will take it on the throw and near midfield. 15 minutes into this one. Still no score here in the Division III Girls Soccer Championships in the central section right here on playonsports.com. Ball headed away by the Scots inside their own goal box as they'll force it out of bounds, giving a chance for the Scots to reset their defense. And as you see, the Scots now improving a little bit more defensively. You know, a chance at a break for the Hawks. Thus far, I see a lot of white jerseys up on the attack. A whistle and a handball. They're called by the Hawks, as I believe it was number 15, Sydney Horanek. Could not gain control of her feet, went off of her arm. And in the arm, between the arm and the hand, it is deemed a handball. 16 minutes into this one, again, still no score. Ball kicked, out of bounds, last touched, I believe it'll be off the Hawks. So the Scots will take the ball here on the inbounds for a throw-in. So switching things up here, number 13, Lizette Barrientos will take it right in front of the Liberty bench. Seeing a couple players in front of her, instead she'll dish it over right near her, losing control. The Hawks trying to wrestle through. Instead, they'll dish it right into the bench. And now this will give the opportunity for the Scots to maybe get a break here. Again on the throw-in, number 19, Alexia Gonzalez here for Highland. Throwing it in back down to Joven. And that's Armiel Joven, who clears it over to the far side across midfield. Saving it, but instead, here come the Hawks. It is a 3-on-3, a chip, a shot, and a dive save. No, but it goes well wide to the right. That was a bad play there by the Scots, trying to find a player along the far side, but you saw a great chance there by the Hawks, but they could not take advantage.
Yeah, Evangeline Gomez-Vivanco just kind of lost her footing there on the far sideline, and Hawks almost had a chance there, but couldn't quite finish the play.
22:30 left. Again, still no score, but again, shot-wise, right now the Hawks with the advantage of about 6-3 in their favor. Ball kicked near midfield. The Hawks, though, head it, but it's in control by the Scots. Liberty, though, hits it out of bounds as Highland here will throw it away up along the far side. A long throw-in far side of midfield. The Hawks, though, on top of the ball. Though the Scots here take it away. Ball kicked off. 50-50 ball will be juggled around back to midfield. Liberty trying to find a player, but instead it's going to be a pinball battle. Though the Hawks will regain control. Trying to find some space. Chipped away. Looking for a spin move, but you see three Highland jerseys on top of the ball. But a foul call instead there against Danny Devine, who tried to spin off the defenders, the three defenders, as a matter of fact, but she gets whistled. Ball goes the other way.
But again, Bridget Brunell really all over the field, able to seal that one and at least start setting something up for the Hawks, and if they can keep doing that, hopefully they'll get a little offensive rhythm if you're a Liberty fan.
Along the far side, hit out of bounds by Olivia Neal. The Scots, the last touch it, as they actually let that one go. Throw in here for the Hawks. 21 minutes to go here in the first half, nearly halfway through. A whistle and another foul call here against the Scots as one of the defenders went on top of a Liberty player. On the free kick here, number 17, Olivia Neal to take the ball. Neal launches it, a short one, and the Scots in control. Here they come, a chance at a fast break, a long pass over to Peyton Armijo along the far side, a whistle, and it'll be a goal kick as that pass was a little bit too far for Armijo to chase. Goal kick coming here for the Hawks. A chance to maybe make the dent on the scoreboard. 20 minutes to go again in the first half. Armijo a little bit too far off on the pass. Again, lost her footing. Had to let that ball go away.
Yeah, and too bad because number two on your screen, Danielle Vargas, really had her defender beat, had a great beat on it if the pass had been a little on the mark, but still having a little trouble with accuracy and setting things up and finishing the plays.
So halfway through in this first half, instead it'll be a foul called again against the Scots. No call there as on the shove there was Sydney Quintero from the Scots. The Scots now back in control. Two players from Highland take the ball away. Now back at midfield. Though the Hawks well on top of the ball as they'll kick it away. They'll head it off there by the Scots. Trying to look for some footwork. There's Randy Wallace. Wallace dishes it to her own player. A whistle and a foul call. And it'll be against the Scots. As I believe on that play, it was Rebecca Vasquez who deemed the culprit on the play. Taking the free kick here for Liberty, number 17, Olivia Neal. 19 minutes to go again in the first half. Neal ready to go. Right to the center of the goal box, a chance at a header, but Vega on top of the save. I believe on that play, I think it was Randy Wallace who had a chance at a header, but the header was right into the hands of Vega. A whistle, ball going out of bounds, and I believe it was last touched by the Scots. Now Liberty with another chance, but instead it'll be a foul called instead. Another chance here for the Hawks to get on that scoreboard. 18:15 to go here in the first half, still a nothing ball game. Neal here to take the free kick along the far side, 45 yards away. In near the top of the goal box, a chance at a shot, but it's gonna be wide to the right. Goal kick coming for the Scots. Already two chances so far, but this is actually, they've had better chances compared to the Scots thus far. This team so far has at least been setting up better than what Highland has done in these first 23 minutes.
Yeah, Scots continuing to set up good chances for themselves.
Inside the goal box, though, Vega chases the ball right in front of Danny Devine, who had a chance at a header, but Vega comes in with the scoop. Ball kicked away over at midfield, as it'll go now towards the far side. Scott's losing control of the ball, though, and now it'll be kicked away. Hawks, though, on top of the ball, looking for a player up along the near side. Here's Devine. Devine along the near side, trying to kick it off the Scots, as they do, giving a chance for the Hawks to bring some more players to working on offense. Kirkson, it was Juliet Olsen there on the kick, and here taking the throw-in will be Wallace. Wallace launching it up into the center of the goal box. A chance at a header, ball over the defenders, but right there is Vega with the stop, almost lost control of the ball. An opportunity again, a third one here in the last minute and a half for the Hawks. They have not capitalized.
But very aggressive, the Hawks, and you have to give Highland credit for stopping really some good breakaways by the Hawks.
Along the near side, Devine launching it right along the lines. It'll be out of bounds. No one there on the ball. Still no score here. Again, this is the Division III soccer final right here on playonsports.com. It's Liberty taking on Highland.
And do you want to watch more of your school's great matchups like the game you're enjoying right here tonight? Tell your school to sign up for the Play On Sports School Broadcast Program. The program allow schools to broadcast all their games and other activities on the web. For more information, go to playonsports.com/SBP. That's playonsports.com/SBP.
And the exciting thing here about Play On Sports is we have six sections here all throughout the state of California, as far as close as south as San Diego. Also, or San Diego. All, obviously, we have a lot of contracts here with the central section of the Central Coast, and even as far north as the northern section. We actually signed up with a brand new section here and the Oakland section as well. So seven total section here, and you'll have all the action from football all the way down to gymnastics right here on PlayOnSports.com. Ball at midfield. The Scots trying to gain control of the ball with some footwork there as Gonzalez losing the ball as it'll be right back into the Scots zone. Liberty, though, kicks it away along the far side. Two Scott players trying to gain control, but instead a chance at a header and a shot going out of bounds wide to the left, just trickling out over the goal line.
The header just a little high. That could have been really dangerous if it was on target.
15 minutes to go here in this first half, and Michael, real quick, directing this to you. You know, 30 or 25 minutes in, just in your opinion, who was at the better advantage so far?
Well, for sure, it's Liberty. Early on, the first couple minutes, it looked like the Scots had the advantage, had some good setups on offense, looked really smooth as they regain control right here. But Liberty's really dominated the possession down the stretch and had a lot of opportunities. Nothing just quite finished, quite in rhythm.
Yeah, a team that you can see a slow start, you know, maybe getting three losses in their first 12 to 13 games thus far, but they've obviously come in with the advantage record-wise. They are 22-3-3, but they've got a two-game winning streak better winning streak compared to Highland. They've come in winning 13 in a row again, as you mentioned, Highland with 11. Although records really don't matter in this final game, but really, you know, these 1-2 seeds, we were basically seeing, you know, the best of the best here in this Division III matchup.
And an issue for the Highland Scots, again, as we said earlier, has been in these playoffs of having slow starts, and it looks like they're kind of suffering that again.
Ball out of bounds here, throwing here taken for the Hawks near midfield. About 13:30 to go again in this first half, and neither team has had a real strong opportunity to get to the goal, although Highland has had more shots. As you see on the screen, it's still nothing. Along the far side, Liberty, though, diving and forcing that ball out of bounds, but this will be a chance here for the Scots to maybe take some control here. Ball out of bounds again, last touch there by the Hawks, as the Scots will take it again for a throw-in, giving a chance for more players to flood in to the Hawks zone. Ball kicked away to the center of the box, but no one there to chase after it. It'll go over the goal line. Goal kick coming here for Liberty. Again, Scots with another chance, but they have not found the chance to at least get around the Liberty defense. As so far, this Liberty defense has really wreaked havoc against the Scots thus far in these first 27 minutes. Liberty there on the goal kick near midfield. The Scots, they're trying to gain control. With the ball, though, is Libula. Looking for a player up along the far side, and that's number 10, Bridget Brunel. Brunel letting that ball go out of bounds. That'll be a throw-in coming, though. It's the last touch by the Scots. Liberty here now on the throw-in into the center of the box. Scots are trying to head this ball away, juggle around along the far side. The Scots with control, but you see a lot of green. They're flooding with the ball. Here's Dallisay along the far side. Cross pass, chance at a shot. Juggle around, pushed off. No foul call, and the Scots kick it away.
Scots might have gotten away with one there, as you know, it looked like Liberty was setting up really well, and the Scots defense looked a little out of sorts, but they got the stop somehow.
And you see Rebecca Vega a little bit winded on the play. She might have gotten touched on a potential kick, but you saw three green jerseys on top of the ball. Any one of them could have had a chance, but again, the Scots maybe getting away with the push-off there, but again, in those kinds of instances, it's the referee's discretion, and usually in those areas there, they let those players play, and that's what the referee did there. Usually in the box, you let those teams get physical, and Liberty could not get something in control there. Scots take the ball from the throw-in by Liberty, a high ball with the ball now at midfield. But 10:45 to go here in this first half. The Scots trying to find something up on the attack. Here is Danielle Vargas. Liberty, though, kicks it away back to midfield. But now here come the Scots. 1-on-3. Liberty winning the ball. A whistle and a foul call against Dallasay, who went off of Vargas. Free kick coming about 30 yards away from the Scots goal. Already 30 minutes in, and this team, both teams have already sped things up. A chance at a high shot, but a scoop save right in front of Allison Seether. Read that ball again rather well. Ball kicked away at midfield, headed away there by the Scots. It'll go towards the near side and out of bounds. Free throw and coming here for the Hawks. Throwing it up along the near sideline as that goes out of bounds. No one there to touch it. The Scots here will take control. Here is Jovan. Jovan, though, kicks it away. Back and forth action here up along the near side. The Hawks will find a chance to maybe take control. Under 10 to go here in this first half. Again, no score in this Division III girls final. Stoppage of play as there's a little bit of commotion there coming from the Highland sideline. Here come the Hawks now up along the near side. Here's Olsen. Olsen trying to give it to Devine, but instead the Scots on top of the ball. Great footwork there by Lizette Barrientos, who kicks it away towards midfield, but right in front of three Liberty players. A whistle, a foul called against. That'll be number 12, Emma Tucker from Liberty. Going the other way here for the Scots. Actually, correction, it'll be going to the Liberty side with the free kick.
Yeah, the Hawks doing a really good job there on defense of reading that and being prepared to stop the attack.
8:35 left to go. Free kick coming as it was trying to be headed away, but instead the Scots on top of the ball. Here is Barrientos, who throws it to midfield, but instead it's picked up by the Hawks. Now the Scots on top of the ball up along the far side. Two green jerseys on top of the ball. But here come now the Hawks. Hawks looking for a player up near midfield, but instead the Scots trying to circle around two Hawk defenders. High kick, one-on-one battle, but instead Liberty will force it out of bounds. Great strategy there by the Scots. Will bring some players in with a chance at an attack. .7:45 to go here in this first half. Again, still no score. As we mentioned in the beginning of the broadcast, we had a feeling this might have been this kind of game where obviously defense will definitely get you the trophy, but it's seeming as if right now that one goal might be the difference in this one tonight.
Yeah, it really is. There's, you know, a lot of good defensive plays, and really the offense is both getting good attacks started, but in terms of when they get in the box, it kind of slows down. The passes aren't quite on the mark, and good defensive stops on both sides.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree, especially with Liberty thus far. You know, they've actually had some chances offensively, though they have not capitalized. But on the other end, when the Scots have tried to get their own breaks, you see a lot of Liberty players getting in front of the ball or closing those gaps. And a chance, another one there, as a matter of fact, a high kick going well out of bounds, and that's what we're talking about there. A chance to maybe position themselves into a chance at a potential shot. Instead, you see at least two Liberty players on top of the defender, and on that play, you see it right there, ball going well out of bounds for a goal kick.
Just a little overkicked again.
Ball here now at near midfield. The Scots, though, in control. 6:25 to go here in this first half. Great spin move there by Quintero, and she'll give it now towards the far side into the far goal box of the Hawks. Watching that ball go out of bounds, and another free kick coming here for Liberty. 6:05 to go here in this first half of play. Again, these first 35 minutes thus far, you can definitely say it has been mostly Liberty thus far, but the Scots have had a couple of breaks go their way. The biggest chance coming about 5 minutes ago when Liberty had Vega lose control of a shot, but a non-foul call gave way for the Scots. Scots now with the ball. Near midfield, in it to the Hawks zone, looking for a player, but instead the Hawks will dish it away. Here with the ball is Olsen. Olsen losing control. A chance for Quintrera to sneak away, but instead the Scots back on top of the ball. Up at midfield, about 30 yards away. Here is Janot. Janot trying to fight off a defender. Will dish it towards the near side, a far pass as it's dive saved. And now here come the Scots, a chance at a shot, but instead it'll be try to force over, now back to midfield. A high shot, but on top of the ball there is Seether, and that's all they had there on that play. Trying to spin move a couple of the defenders. You saw Quintero and Janot try to fight off the defenders. Both chances, they could not regain control. Scots will kick it away up along the far side, looking for Gonzalez, but it's way too deep for her, going out of bounds.
And here on the near side, Gonzalez doing a really good job just a minute ago of beating her defender, Juliet Olsen. It looked actually like Olsen had it set up on defense, but Gonzalez did a really good job of reading the play all the way from way before she had the ball to start setting up that play. They just couldn't keep the momentum going and quite set up the offense once they got deeper towards the Liberty goal.
Ball at midfield now, under 4 minutes to go here in this first half of play. A push off and a whistle and a foul called against Liberty. You had two Liberty defenders on top of the player from the Scots. They could not get away with the foul call there. 3:35 left to go here in this first half. Taking the free kick here will be Sydney Quintero. About 2 yards away from midfield up along the far side. Clock here ticking, and the clock does not stop unless there's a goal scored or for a card, either yellow or red. Ball into the pile on top of the Liberty goal box, although the Hawks regain possession. Here they come, a chance on the attack. Here is Jovan. Correction, Burnell, who gets the ball taken away by Gomez. Gomez throws it to midfield. The Hawks, though, regaining control. Looking for Devine. Now passes it over to Wallace. Wallace now moves the ball at midfield. Trying to find a player. She's got one up along the far side. Too high on the pass there to Burnell. As the Scots on top of the ball. Here's Jovan. Jovan, though, gives it back to a Hawk player. Devine heads it away. The Scots trying to regain control, and now here come the Hawks with the chance of the attack, but the defender from the Scots, kicks it away out of bounds right in front of the Highland bench.
Yeah, Scots know that Burnell is really, really dangerous over there on that far side and have done a pretty good job of marking her the last minute or so.
About 2:15 left to go. The Hawks with the ball along the far side at midfield. A whistle and another foul called against Quintero from the Scots. 2 minutes left to go. Again, still no score thus far in these first 38 minutes. And again, we're definitely seeing your traditional 1-2 battle here. Clock here, though, stopped. It does stop here in these final 2 minutes. In fact, it'll be by the referee's discretion. So in the final 2 minutes here in the first half, it'll be a referee's discretion. In the second half, it will be the final 10. Hawks with the ball, running into the defender of number 17, Paige Janot, and Janot gets called for the foul. A hard one at that as she ran right into Randy Wallace along the far side as she's got to take a quick breather. Ball here now thrown in. Scots, though, on top of the ball. Here they come. Here's Vargas at midfield, trying to get around the defender, as she does. Looking at the center, it's going to be an offside call as Peyton Armijo was just a step too far ahead from two Liberty players. Just unlucky there. Free kick coming.
Yeah, and she knew it. She tried to adjust at the last minute when she saw the pass coming, but it was just a little too late.
Ball now kicked away at midfield. The Scots on top of the ball once again. Trying to dive save here, but instead the Scots will regain control. But now here comes Liberty. Maybe, no, it'll be taken away again by the Scots. Trying to force the ball back to midfield. Here's Quintero with the ball. Loses control. Ball juggled around, but here is Wallace who gives it over down to Brower. Brower looking for Devine. A whistle and another foul, and it'll be a yellow card coming. And that'll be against number 10, Arielle Jovan, as she's got to step off for this play. And that's crucial. You lose a man. Correction, actually, you lose a man here because of the yellow card. Got to sub her out, as coming in now will be Alexia Gonzalez. Correction, will be number 15, Alexandria Diosdado, who has to come in first. You lose one of your key starters here on these last few minutes. Taking the free kick here will be Wallace. Bridget Arendi Wallace, for that matter.
And Diosdado, only a sophomore. We'll see how she does coming in this big moment.
Ball headed over. I believe it will be a corner kick coming as it was off of, I believe it was Lizette Barrientos. So Barrientos heads it away, but at least that'll give him a little bit of a break. But the first corner kick here will be given for the Hawks.
And the Hawks' offense has kind of gone silent in the last few minutes. Not sure if that's a conditioning factor, again, from playing a game on Wednesday. Was it Wednesday or Thursday it was? But getting another chance here.
A chance at a shot, though, kicked away there by the Scots. A big wall forcing it out of bounds. Trying to find that last-second break as Quintero could not gain control. Now chasing the ball after it again is Vargas, who lets the ball go out of bounds. Throw in here coming for the Scots. They got to hurry. There's not much time here on the clock thus far. There's the last 2 minutes will be discretion by the referee. Ball headed away at midfield, and that will be halftime. So it's still no score here. 40 minutes have been played here in this Division III Girls Soccer Championships in the Central Section. No score between Liberty and Highland. Michael, real quick, your thoughts.
Liberty definitely looked like the sharper team offensively early. Had a lull late in the half, but Scots again struggling, I think, from another slow start as they've had throughout these playoffs, really.
So it's still a no-score contest after 40 minutes of play. We'll have a 10-minute halftime, and we'll come back here for the second half of play. This is the Division III Girls Soccer Championships right here on PlayOnSports.com, where high school sports lives right
Ladies
here. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back.
The CIF Division III Championship shirts down there. They're selling for $20.
Back in action here in the second half here again alongside Michael Conowitz here. Manny Nude is making the call, and Dan, our camera guy, moving the camera back and forth. Again, it's a no-score battle here in the first 40 minutes of play as the second half is just underway. And again, Liberty, though, has the shot advantage, and you can kind of make the argument to say that they've got the upper hand area in these first 40 minutes, but the Scots so far have at least kind of knocked on the door a little bit, even though they have not had as many better chances compared to Liberty. They've at least kind of, messed around with them a little bit and at least kind of seeing what their defense has done so far.
They have had some opportunities, and it'll also be interesting to watch, as we mentioned a couple times in this first half. Now down the stretch, how conditioning plays a factor. Highland had more days to recover, sit back, and really scout Liberty, and Liberty had the rain delay, so they had to play their game later in the week, had a little less rest. We'll see how the conditioning plays a factor, or maybe it won't.
And speaking of conditioning factor too, the weather also playing a factor here, even though it is not as cold as it was when they played their games a couple days back. The current weather right now, it is sitting at around 50 thus far here in Bakersfield. So although it's, again, not as chilly, definitely fatigue will definitely play a huge part, especially in those final 10 minutes when, as we mentioned, the last 10 minutes of soccer in any boys or girls is definitely the best soccer to come. And obviously, as we said before in the beginning of the broadcast, it is looking to be as if one goal may be the difference here in this one. Ball here at midfield. Again, the Hawks will be this time going from right to left. If you're just joining us, they'll be dressed in their green with white lettering and green shorts. Liberty, or the Hawks, or the Scots for that matter, in their white jersey with green lettering. Ball off the feet of Liberty defender Sydney Horanek as it goes out of bounds. Throw in coming now for the Scots. About 2.5 minutes in to this second half. Again, still no score. A whistle as a bad throw in there by the Scots will revert the ball the other way. Not a lot of mistakes defensively as well here for both teams. Although Liberty's had some better shot opportunities, both teams have really not let up in either category on defense, and they've really kind of stood their ground here in their first 43 minutes.
Yeah, both have made good stops and just played solid fundamental defense.
Ball out of bounds here. Free throw-in coming here for the Scots. And already in these first 3 minutes, we've seen a little bit more explosion coming from this Scots team. Ball thrown in along the far sideline. Out of bounds again. Right in the same spot for a second chance. At midfield, though, taken away here by the Hawks. The Scots, though, on top of the ball. Here is Diosdado, who came in for Alexia Gonzalez for the yellow card. She has a yellow card and is at the bench right now. A whistle and a foul called against the Scots, and it'll be against Samantha Abarca of Highland. 36-25 to go again here in this second half. Once again, still no score, as you see there on the top of your screen. Ball kicked away right into the pile of the Scots, forcing that ball back to midfield. The Hawks, though, regain control. They'll dish it towards the near side, but on the takeaway, there is Diosdado. Diosdado now with the ball again at near midfield along the near side. Ball forced out of bounds, though it's last touch there by number 7, Juliana Liuba. And actually be a throw in here for the Hawks. With the chest, ball now at midfield, kicked away by Diosdado. A doubleheader there. Keeping the ball in midfield, and here's Quintero. Quintero passing it towards the near side, looking for a chance at the attack. Here's Janot. Janot losing control as it's taken away by Liuba of Liberty. Out of bounds, trying to find Danny Devine along the near side. A little off as it goes out of bounds. Throwing here coming for the Scots. 35-17 to go again in this second half. Ball taken away there by the Hawks, as it'll go along midfield again, out of bounds. They cannot work that line there along the near side. Throwing now coming again for the Scots as Vasquez will take it. Vasquez launches it off the line this time. Divine trying to gain control, but it's taken away here by the Scots. Here's Jovan. Jovan looking for a player, but instead it's on top of a green defender. Janot up along now the far side. Here come the Scots, a chance at a pass along the box, though it goes out of bounds. Scooped up there by Seether, but it goes well over the goal line. Goal kick coming here for the Hawks.
Yeah, both teams offensively have had trouble once it really gets past the midfielders of keeping the offensive momentum going.
Near 6 minutes in, and again, the Scots, at least in these first 6 minutes so far, have actually played a little bit better than they've had in the first half. Shot chances have not really come their way, but at least defensively, they've kind of upped the ante a little bit more here in these first 6 to 7 minutes of the second half.
They've had better possessions and certainly some good play on defense.
At midfield on the throw, and here come the Scots with a chance. Juggled around as it's launched. But instead, with the ball here, scooping it up is Seether. A line drive right in front of Seether with the easy save. Kicked away at midfield, headed off. Here by Liberty, here's Liuba. Along the near side, kicked away. Divine trying to gain control, but instead goes out of bounds. Throwing coming again for the Scots. They really love that near side trying to work it, but Divine and Liuba have not connected here so far in the second half. Thrown in here by the Scots. As in control is Randy Wallace. Wallace launching it towards the far side of midfield, but instead the Scots on top of the ball, though taken away. Here's Burnell. Burnell dishing it towards the far side. A cross shot, and it's going to be wide to the left. Out of bounds. Goal kick for the Scots.
Burnell, though, again, doing just a great job of sneaking in there and grabbing that one, and then a nice pass over to the far side. They just couldn't quite get it done once they broke away.
But definitely a better possession there this time around here for Liberty. You know, the last couple of plays that they've had, they've tried to work on Liuba and Divine, but that time around they forced the ball out towards the far side. And here's another chance, but it'll be a little bit too far for Juliet Olsen to gain control. Another out-of-bounds play. Goal kick coming here again for the Scots, but at least in those, you know, last two possessions, they've at least kind of improved a little bit on the offensive act. 8 minutes in here in this second half again, still no score here live at Scotland Yard in Highland High School. Again, the Division III Girls Soccer Championships right here on playonsports.com. With the ball now, here is Burnell off the feet of a Scot player. Throwing now coming for the Hawks, as they'll give it right into the Scots box. Along the far side sideline, out of bounds, last touched by Liberty. Scots here with the throw-in. Instead, it'll actually be a free kick instead. It was a late foul call up along the sideline. Ball kicked away towards the center of the pitch. Quintero with the ball. Nice spin move to set up the ball. A chance to go on the attack, but a little bit far off the ball was Samantha Abarca, who could not chase the pass. From Daniel Vargas, throw-in coming here for the Hawks.
And you know, you have, again, beautiful plays by players individually. They're just not all quite getting on the same page. Vargas did a great job of positioning there, reading the play, and getting the ball, but just an overpass.
Little tangle up near midfield. The Scots trying to fight its way through. Now they regain control. Looking for a cross pass along the near side, going out of bounds. Chasing after it, Peyton Armijo, but about a few yards off the ball. Throwing here now for the Hawks. And with possession is Liuba. Going out of bounds, a whistle and a foul called, as that's going to be against Diaz Dodo.
Liuba hit the grassless pitch there. Hard. We could hear the hit on the ground from up here and coming up a little slowly.
Now we actually have a throw in here for the Scots, but the referee is now discussing. The referee did wave the flag and did not actually point where the ball was going to go. And now there's the correct call. So it'll be a free kick coming here for Liberty. I guess a little confusion there on the field as the Scots are ready to throw the ball in, but I guess the referees had to discuss once again. Yeah, the referee did not make the signal if the ball went out of bounds or not, but he actually waved his flag, and usually that's because of a foul call, so Liberty will gain possession here. On the kick is Liuba along the sideline, and once again looking for Devine, cannot connect.
Passing has just been an issue for both these teams tonight.
A throw-in coming, and again, in a game like this, when you have a lot of open space, this is obviously a football track and soccer field, and when you have no one working around the sidelines or even around the goal box as well, if the ball goes deep, it's going to go far, and that precious time will be ticking, and that might play a factor in these final 5 to 10 minutes here in this one. Flag is up, and it'll be a foul called against, once again, the Scots. Taking the free kick along the near side is Randy Wallace, who launches it near the top of the box, though the Scots head it away. Two defenders on, and then Quintero there on the takeaway. Kicked off there by Vasquez, but he gives it there for Liberty. Scots still on top of the ball again. Here they come with a chance on the attack. Here is Vasquez, spins off a defender. Now up to the center, here is Vasquez. A chance at a deep shot, wide! Seether makes the dive save along the sideline, keeping it, no! Could not keep it in bounds, a goal kick coming. Should have let that go. That would have been a corner kick coming, but a great dive save there by Allison Seether with the kick from Paige Janot. The Highland fans not appreciating that call, but Seether with an impressive dive save.
That was a really clutch save there, and now another opportunity for the Scots.
A high shot there by Quintero, way off the goal, and that'll be a goal kick.
Scots seeming to start getting a little momentum here offensively.
27:40 to go, and like you mentioned, and as we mentioned in the beginning of this second half, we've already seen the Scots with a couple of chances, and that was by far their best thus far. Goal kick coming, a short one. Quintero heads it, looking for Vasquez. A chance at a shot, a little bit high over the goalpost. Unfortunately, that's not three. That's going to be out of bounds.
And you got to credit number 17, Olivia Neal, down there on your screen. Really good job of chasing down the attack and making a good shot tough.
13 minutes into this one, and the Scots playing Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde. They've looked like a completely different team here in the beginning stages of the second half. Still a nothing-nothing ball game, though, here in this Division III final. Quintero looking for the ball. She comes in on the takeaway, shoving a player down. No foul call. Ball going out of bounds. It'll be going to the Scots. Ooh, Quintero playing very physically. If she'll find a chance to maybe, play a little shoulder there with the referee behind her, she'll take the advantage. Ball kicked away. It'll be out of bounds off the honks as the Scots here will throw it in.
You can feel the Highland energy both in the crowd and really on the field, really finally finding some energy, finding some rhythm offensively. They've had slow starts, but they've overcome them to get here.
Dallas A there with a great defensive stop up along the near side, as you saw right there, trying to force off of Ariel Jovan. Could not get around. A goal kick coming here for the Hawks. Ball kicked away. Back here for the Scots. Finding its way through. Chance at a shot, juggled around, still loose. And the Hawks push that ball away. They get a lucky break and they'll keep it in bounds. Scots, though, again in control. A whistle. Not sure what the call is, but the Scots will gain possession. Actually, it'll be a foul called. No, correction, it'll be a throw in there instead.
And Vega for Highland really getting a lot of action and bailing out the Scots quite a bit in the last couple minutes.
Dallas A kicking the ball out of bounds into the Highland bench. Throw-in coming here for the Scots. And again, 15 minutes thus far in the second half, and the Highland team is playing much differently compared to the first. Ball headed in to the Scots box. Trying to gain control is Vargas, though kicked out of bounds. Throw in coming here for the Scots at the right corner of the Highland goal. Throwing it in, looking for Vasquez. A whistle, and it'll be an offside call. As you see two Highland players well in front of a bunch of green jerseys, ball going the other way.
A good possession for the Scots, certainly a couple good possessions and some really good saves on defense for Liberty.
Yeah, you definitely have to give credit to this Scots team thus far. They've had a couple of great chances, much better compared to the first half, as we mentioned. But so far, this Liberty defense has still not let anything go by. Another short kick there by the Hawks on the free one. Ball going out of bounds, and you know, seeing these free kicks here for Liberty, stronger in the first half, but in the second half, not so much. And that's been one big reason why the Scots have actually taken control.
And you know, they just came out of the break, so I don't know if we can just assume the conditioning factor is becoming an issue for Liberty. But down the stretch, we'll see if it continues to look that way.
Liberty again with another free kick, about 30 seconds apart. Another line drive, and again the Scots almost had a chance, but instead it'll be the Hawks who kick it away. Out of bounds, though, it'll go to Highland. Throw in coming up along the far side, trying to get around a defender going out of bounds. Another throw in here, and it's off the feet of Juliet Olsen. Here they come on the attack. The two Hawk players take it away. Divine on the header. The Scots, though, take it away, but that'll be a foul. About 22:50 left thus far, and when it was all Liberty in the first half, it's been all Highland here in these first 20 or so minutes in this second half. Liberty trying to gain possession. Divine trying to head it in front of her, but instead goes out of bounds. Throw in coming here for the Scots. On the throw in there is Diosdado. Quintero lets it go out of bounds off the Scots, or correction, off the Hawks. The Scots here will throw it again. Diosdado here will take the ball as we'll move it closer to the goal. About 10 yards closer for that matter. Looking for Quintero, and that's where she'll give it to. Who lost control as the Hawks will force it out towards midfield. Ball now headed off. Here is Janot trying to spin her way out of two defenders, trying to find a break, though on the dive kick is Horenic. Going out of bounds, now the Scots will take it on the throw along the far side. Janot with the ball, trying to get around a defender. Round two, as a matter of fact. Trying to use some footing. Great footwork along the corner. The Hawks, though, kick it off. A chance at a shot, a high one over the goal. And a goal kick coming. 21:25 left in Highland. Again, another great opportunity, but they have not found that chance to get that ball into the back of the net. Another free kick coming in line drive. Divine on top of the ball. Actually had the ball go too far off of her. Now chasing after it is Gonzalez along the corner, who lets that ball go out of bounds. Throw in coming here for Liberty. Liberty here on the throw, looking for Divine along the far side, but taking that ball away is Janot. Liberty, though, will launch it along the line and out of bounds. And another throw in here coming for the Scots.
It has been a long time since Liberty has had the ball offensively. The ball has even crossed midfield. You do have to start wondering if that conditioning is a factor in favor of the Scots.
Again, the Hawks have come in with a better record and a better winning streak. 13 in a row, 22-3-3 overall. Highland 11 in a row, 19-6-2. But again, as you mentioned, maybe the conditioning factor may wreak havoc here as we approach 20 minutes left to go in this second half. Or for that matter, it might be regulation A chance at a break. Though on top of that ball, Rebecca Vega with her first save of this second half. Kicks it away. Devine on the header. The Scots on top of the ball, a whistle and a foul. It'll be a handball called against the Scots. As now here come the Liberty team to maybe get some breaks going here.
Finally with a chance to set up something offensively.
Wallace here taking the free kick about 10 yards off of midfield. A line drive, though the Scots well on top of the ball. A long pass looking for Daniel Vargas along the far side. Could not save it. Inbounds. Just goes over the chalk. And it'll be a throw-in coming here for Liberty. But again, these line drives have actually come from pretty much everybody during those free kicks here for Liberty. And Wallace's feet has actually been the main player here for Liberty to take the free kicks. And they've actually gone shorter each time. Not sure if it, like you mentioned, Michael, if it might be either the conditioning factor or she might be a little bit too fatigued taking those kicks. She's actually done quite a bit here in these first 60 minutes. Scott's here on top of the ball. Here is Janot trying to spin her way out. Devine takes the ball away, but Devine, who gets called for the foul. Getting a bit more chilly. Still about 50 or so degrees, I believe 57, but again, with the air a little bit humid, you can definitely feel the weather up here. 18 minutes to go here in this second half, still nothing, as neither side has really had a very good chance to at least attack the goal. Ball going out of bounds off the Scots. Taking the throw in here will be Liberty's Juliana Liuba. Again, going out of bounds, again off the Scots, as Leo will move closer to midfield. Launches the ball, headed by Devine. The Scots, though, on top of the ball. But now Liberty there on the takeaway. Wallace launching it, looking for Olsen along the far side, but way off the ball, out of bounds. Throw-in coming here for the Scots. About 17:20 left to go. Now here is Devine. Devine with a chance at a line drive, but it's stopped there by two Scott defenders. Losing your footing there. I believe that was Barrientos, who could not control the ball, and now Wallace will take the throw-in here for Liberty. This might give a chance for Liberty to get another opportunity. Into the goal box, though, the Scots well on top of the ball again. Wallace in control, though, for Liberty. In front of two Scott defenders, trying to dish it out. Juggled around, flag is up, foul is called, and it'll go the other way.
A little bit of progress for Liberty there. Finally getting the ball a little deeper into Scott's territory, but Highland just really kind of does look like they have more energy, faster legs here in the second half.
Yeah, this Scots team thus far has really not let up. And again, with a short break, you can kind of just tell that maybe Liberty kind of used up most of their energy in that first half. They have looked like a completely different team in these first 25 minutes of this second half of play. Liberty here, another foul call. The Scots with a free kick, and again, taking it is Diosdado. Ball players bunched up on the top of the Liberty goal box. A high kick that will be scooped up by Allison Cedar. An easy one at that. She'll kick the ball away at midfield. Quintero, though, heads it. Though Wallace on top of the ball here for the Hawks. Wallace trying to spin away out of Quintero as she'll kick it away back to midfield. The Scots on top of the ball. Liberty trying to play some defensive footwork there. But now the Scots trying to move the ball back to midfield. Wallace trying to fight her way. Falls down looking for a foul call. Doesn't get it. Quintero there on the takeaway. But here is Devine. Devine again losing her footing, getting tripped up. Quintero chasing after the ball. Out of bounds. But it'll be going here for Liberty. Liuba here on the throw-in. About 30 yards away off goal. Near side. Wallace trying to look for Devine, but it goes out of bounds. Now the ball will go the other way. Here on the throw-in, Liuba on the header. Quintero on the kick. Another header by the Scots as launching it up in the air is Horarik into the corner and out of bounds, and I believe that will be a throw-in just in front of the corner.
And even at times when the Scots have looked outnumbered when they've started attacks, they seem to just be able to set things up well, although Liberty gets it back right here.
Yeah, a big mistake there on the throw-in. Didn't even go 3 yards as that ball was along the chalk and out of bounds there on the launch. So now Liberty can maybe take advantage of this Scots mistake. Very few mistakes have actually come from this game on either side. Both teams playing near perfect soccer in these first 65. Ball headed over, still bunched around along the chalk and out of bounds. Goal kick coming. Again, the Scots flooding up the middle of the box, giving a huge break there for Rebecca Vega.
And that was really a huge opportunity for Liberty. Very few opportunities that close to the goal.
Devine trying to gain control, but instead it'll be Janot on the ball. Janot passing it along the far side, now looking for a player, trying to find a defender, juggled over as Cedar with the dive save. And you can definitely credit Dallasay on the play as well to make that last second stop to give Cedar the chance to make the save.
Absolutely, but you see there, even when it was 3-on-1, it looked to be in the favor of Highland.
Yeah, 3-on-1 there, but you know, that one player for Liberty made herself look like two, if not three, and she gave a huge break there for Allison Cedar to make that last second save. Scott's now with the ball as they'll kick it towards midfield. Trying to find its way over as the ball taken away there by Diosdado. Now Janot with the ball inside the Liberty zone. Passed up along the far side, looking for another chance, though it's off the feet. And I believe it will be a corner up along the corner of the far side, as a matter of fact, as it's off the feet of Sydney Horanek.
And now the Scots passing looking much more sharp, especially on this last possession and really in the last few minutes.
So the first corner of the night here for the Scots, it'll be along the far side, 12 minutes and counting here in the second half, if not regulation. Quintero lost control. Janot with the shot, but it's weak to the right. She had a lot of space in front of her, but somehow she lost control of that ball. She could have at least line drived it towards the center, but her footing was a little bit off. 11:35 left to go. And my favorite part, Michael, the last 10 minutes of soccer will be coming shortly. And you can just tell the aggressiveness is definitely building here as, like we mentioned, one goal will most likely do it, and either team does not want to be the one who concedes it.
And now experience also in favor of the Scots as Highland, the two-time defending champions here.
Scots here on the free kick after the foul there by the Hawks. In to the Liberty goal box, headed away though by the Hawks. Great play as Quintero with a high kick going well out of bounds. And again, time now playing a factor with the ball not near the goal. It's way deep, about 15 yards off, and they got to chase after it. Precious seconds coming off the clock.
Tonight's game, there will be an awards presentation, so please remain in the stands until after.
Free kick coming as Wallace will take it again. Wallace, who's been kind of losing her footing. And Quintero is actually down on the field right now. Sydney Quintero with a player down right now. Clock is still ticking. Again, the referee does have the main clock on the field, and I believe he will stop the clock. So I think in the last 10 minutes, the referee will actually have control of the clock. So they will get some extra minutes out of here on this injury. Though Quintero, as she will be slowly getting up here. I think she might be favoring her right ankle. She's got her left knee up. I think she might have maybe aggravated her ankle or her right knee.
And Quintero, only a freshman, but the fourth leading scorer for the Scots, 9 goals on the season.
Yeah, a lot of players here for Highland who have really done a lot of damage to the back of the net. And, you know, like we've mentioned throughout this whole broadcast here, you know, 3 players came in with double-digit scoring affairs. Janot, Gonzalez, and Armijo. Janot and Armijo actually have 17 goals apiece, and one of them being the freshman, Alexi Gonzalez, who has 12. And a lot of these players, though, you know, coming in with a lot of experience. As you look down the roster, a couple of seniors here and there, but they're definitely piling with a lot of sophomores and freshmen. So, you know, looking at this team right now, again, experience comes into play, but they really know how to build with a lot of youth.
They do, and it looks like Quintero, you know, being helped off the field and actually being carried off now by several teammates. She was kind of hobbling off, but looks like hopefully not too serious, but the Scots may have lost her for the last 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, her right ankle does not look very good as she's being tended to on the sideline. And I, like you mentioned, I think she might be done. So with the player coming in now, can't make out who it is, though, but you definitely lose one of your prime defenders and even set up players here on offense. On the kick, the Scots, though, headed over, trying to gain control as they look for Caitlin Jones, the one that came in. Correction, Haley Curtis, though, on the ball as it goes out of bounds. Goal kick coming here with 7:50 to go in the second half. Still 50 degrees out here, as it's getting a little bit chilly as this night wears on. Divine fighting for the ball, a whistle and a foul call, and that's going to go against Divine. The Scots here with another chance. They'll take the free kick. Joven here to take it now for Highland. 7:20 to go in this second half. Joven into the pile, though. It's kicked away by Wallace. Ball pushed over to the far side, going out of bounds, and that'll give the Scots a chance to throw this ball in. 7:10 left to go. And still no score here. One goal might do it in this one. Trying to find her way around it. Looking for a player, though, kicked away as Wallace will dish it along the far side as it'll go out of bounds. 6:50 left to go. Ball headed out, trying to gain control is Olsen. Olsen with the ball well in front of her as the Scots will launch it along the sideline. Now here comes Janot. Janot trying to turn on those jets, instead gets stopped, but regains control of the ball. Looking for a spin move, almost getting the ball taken away, trying to get around 2 defenders, forcing himself along the far side, trying to go up against Olsen, going out of bounds, and she wins the battle. Foul called. It'll be the Scots here on the free kick.
Janot, a great job of footwork there and being patient, also just taking a pause to see the defenders coming at her and get out of that tough situation, and really all the Scots just quicker to the ball in the second half.
6 minutes left to go, but again, on the clock it says 6 minutes. The referee has the time on the field. Kicked away there by Janot, a line drive headed, but Cedar lost control, and it goes in! My goodness! Peyton Armijo with the header! Into the hands of Seether, slips off her hands, and into the back of the net.
And that really could be the championship there. Obviously, just a tough break there. She had it right in her hands, and just, you know, it's been a long game. Got a lot of action her way and made some good plays in that first half. Just a mistake there. Tough.
Armijo gets a gift, and she might give the ultimate gift of all. And that could be a Central Section Championship. 1-0 to score. 5 minutes and counting here in this second half. Scotland fans might be feeling it here. Scotland Yard fans, for that matter, might be feeling it as they're up along the far sidelines. Liberty there trying to cheer on their team to maybe avenge from that goal. Ball going out of bounds here. Another throw in here for the Scots. 4:29 left to go. So it was Armijo with the goal and the assist from Paige Janot. Devine keeping the ball along the sideline, but it goes just out of bounds. Looking a little winded, and now again, like you said, fatigue now playing a huge factor as now Liberty has to play catch-up, and they've got to use all their energy here in these last few minutes.
And see, there's obviously really frustrated down their end goal. You know, a tough break for her, but again, we got to emphasize, made some really good stops in the first half and even down the stretch of the second half.
Liberty here trying to fight its way through. Devine on the chest, no foul call. Going out of bounds, throw in coming. I believe it will be for the Scots, yes. No, correction, it'll be for the Hawks for that matter. Clock here taking 3:35 left. Wallace here taking the throw. In it to the box. Headed off, out of bounds. Wallace will again throw it in. Launches it over, deep into the box. Headed, juggled around, going out of bounds, and I think it'll stay in front of the stick. Another throw in here coming for Liberty. 3:10 left. Wallace again on the throw. Looking for a nice spot to throw it into the box. She'll throw it near the center. Headed over, and it will be a corner. Yes, along the near side. So that might be their best opportunity here in these final few minutes. Players now spread out with most of them bunched up right in front of the goal. The launch, the header over the crossbar. Oh, a beautiful opportunity, but just over the stick.
So Liberty, despite giving up that big goal on a tough break, really, setting up some good opportunities there for themselves offensively this game. You know, it's ticking down. Time's certainly an issue, but some of the staff on the Hawks sideline walking down the sideline to the opposite side to give Cedar some words of encouragement, because you know the Hawks still have a chance. They had some chances there, and Cedar just needs to make sure that if the ball does come back her way, she doesn't let one mistake become two.
A minute 55 left as the clock does stop, so it'll be the referee's discretion here. The Hawks on top of the ball, trying to fight its way back to midfield as they'll dish it over, though the Scots will force that ball out of bounds. So the clock now at zero on the board, but the referee will have control. There was an injury earlier, so there might be a few more minutes added on here, and he will be the one to blow the final whistle. With the spin move, the Hawks trying to gain control, but it's off the feet of Olsen. Out of bounds here, the Scots will take the throw in. And now, if you're the Scots right now, what do you do? Do you go after for the second goal right away, or do you just kind of play patient here?
Oh, I think you play patient, try and back it out as much as you can, just kick it around in the backfield and milk that clock.
So, a foul called against the Hawks, and precious seconds taken off the clock as it was last touch there by the Hawks on the kick. And that last touch there might be a disadvantage there for Liberty here.
Yeah, getting very late. They need a quick steal and set up an attack right now.
A high kick up along the far side as it'll go out of bounds. Last touch there by Liberty. The Scots playing very conservatively as they're not really attacking the goal. They're kind of just letting the time tick away here. Again, with that one goal advantage. And again, like we mentioned, mistakes have come very few and far between. Liberty, again, trying to avenge that mistake there by Cedar, who expected the ball, but again, slipped off her hands from the header by Armijo. Now here comes Liberty with a chance. The Scots, though, will kick it away. Devine trying to gain control, but the Scots well on top of the ball. And now you see two white jerseys on the spin move. Here is Janot. Janot trying to get off the defender as it's kicked away there by Wallace. Near midfield, headed off by the Scots. A whistle and a foul, and it will go against the Hawks. And that's going to be against number 13, Lizette, correction, not Michaela Brower. A little shaken up there as she played up against Janot. Again, the referee with the time, and I was assume that there might be less than 2 minutes left to go here in this Division III championship. On the line drive, into the hands of Seether in front of the ball. She's got to hurry. Kicks the ball away, a deep one at midfield. Devine with control, but she gets called for another foul with a player down, and she will get a card. Oh, and that's huge. She's got to come off the field, and that's one of your prime setup men.
And really, I think just desperation here at the end for Liberty, and also just conditioning. They just have looked a little slower and slower throughout the second half.
So now the clock does stop after the foul call, so that actually give a little bit of an advantage here for the Hawks. Though the Scots here will take the ball after the foul call. Devine at the bench. Ball kicked away towards the far side. Clock here still going. Wallace in control, who launches it deep, looking for Burnell. Losing control, the Scots again with the ball. But now here comes Liberty again. Here is Hosnell. Now back with the ball. Here's Olsen. Olsen back to Hosnell. A whistle. And Liberty will set up here for the free kick. Wallace here will take it.
And you really have to think here, this might be the last opportunity for the Hawks.
Last one or two chances. The line drive just over the crossbar. A sure opportunity, like you mentioned, Michael. But it was just over the white. And with that ball deep, again, both balls deep into the and near the fence. That clock here still ticking. You hear the Scots fans over there shouting three-peat, looking for their third title in a row here in this Division III final. And they might be getting it, pending that time on the clock. Ball kicked away, a short one at that. As the Scots will try to get control, but the Hawks there with maybe one last chance going out of bounds. The Scots here will take it again on the throw-in. Very good crowd on hand, as you see there deep along the far side, the Scots fans really turning out Highland as well, as they made the hike 2 hours south, or 2 hours north from Fresno. Looking for Olsen along the far side, chasing after it, and that will do it! The Highland Scots will three-peat as CIF Division III champions. They will win this one by a final of 1-0. A valiant effort by both teams, but the Scots are one goal better.
Campuses would like to congratulate both teams on a game well played. This time we'd like to remind you to please stay in the stands after the players have
I think the Scots just had a little longer legs, maybe the advantage of a longer time between the semifinal and the final game. As again, if you joined us late, the Hawks did have a little bit of a rain delay to have one or two days less between their semifinal win and today. So some better legs, I think, quicker legs in the second half for Highland. And obviously the tough mistake for Seether in goal. But really, she did play valiantly, had a lot of Ball has come her way, and except for that one mistake, played a pretty darn good game.
Yeah, both teams again with a great effort, but you know, you can definitely credit that mistake as, again, you look over to see they're getting condoled by some of her teammates there, and as she's the one that's definitely taken it the hardest. But again, you know, both teams really played a great, great effort. Highland, though, one game better. And again, you know, this Highland team really just gave it their all, and they really just took control. And those last, really those whole 40 minutes in that second half, they really came out as that better team. So we'll take a quick timeout here again. The Highland Scots, your Division III CIF, Division III Central Section Champions. They will win it here by a final score of 1-0. Stick around, folks. We'll get you our player of the game and final thoughts right here. This is the CIF Division III Central Section Final here, right here on PlayOnSports.com, where high school sports lives right here.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome back here to PlayOnSports.com. Once again, your Highland Scots, the Division III Central Section Champions here in girls soccer. And a big debate here for our players of the game. Wanted to give it to one, but we're going to actually give it to two, as a matter of fact. The one that set up that game-winning goal, Paige Janot, on that free kick into the head of Peyton Armijo, into the hands of Cedar, but again, sneaking over. But again, it was that setup that gave him that 1-0 advantage and that CIF trophy.
Yeah, both set that play up very well, and you know, throughout the game, both had the ball at their feet really the entire game, and such an important part of that offensive attack for the Scots.
So again, both those players, your Play On Sports player of the game, but again, a valiant effort there from both teams. Definitely give a lot of credit to Liberty. I mean, they came out firing, but in that second half, that you could just tell that they kind of just went out of sync, and like you said, fatigue might have played a factor here and there. But if it weren't, obviously, if it weren't for that goal, we'd still be actually playing a game right now, as a matter of fact. But definitely give a lot of credit to this Liberty team to really play a near complete 80 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. A 13-game win streak ends here in the championship. But in that first half, before it looked like they slowed down a little bit, played really well offensively, and really in much of the first half dominated the Scots. So you got to really give them credit. Not by any means a blowout or anything like that. A really valiant effort in the championship game, and just lost to now the three time in a row champions.
So that'll do it here in this one from all of us here. Dan, our camera guy, Michael, my color guy. This is Manny Nunes here right here on PlayOnSports.com. You can actually catch our player of the game interview on demand. It'll be coming as early as tomorrow. As a matter of fact, this game will be on demand as early as tonight. So if you want to watch this game over and over, you can catch it right here on YouTube at PlayOnSports.com. And we've actually got DVDs sold, which will be in copy starting next week. We're not done here, folks. We'll be back up north in Fresno, California for all divisions from Division VI all the way to Division I for both boys and girls basketball next Friday and Saturday afternoon and night. You can catch the action right here on PlayOnSports.com. And hey, if Highland makes it to the regional final, we've actually got exclusive coverage of the regional final, the Southern California regional final right here. Everything will be caught here on PlayOnSports.com, from soccer also to basketball as well. Real quick, Michael, any final thoughts here in this one?
Just a great championship for Highland, you know, you could tell that they had the experience, and I think in the end that really won the game for them, along with, you know, just more energy throughout and down the stretch, quicker legs.
Definitely, and, you know, definitely give a credit to Highland as they came out the victors here in this one. From all of us here again on playonsports.com, we're signing off here. We'll see you next week in Fresno at Cellon Arena for the CIF Central Section Basketball Championships. Good night, and we'll see you Friday afternoon.